Hello there. Welcome back to Bible Story Time. If this is your first time watching our Bible Story Time, welcome. We're so excited you're here. And if you've seen the other ones, I know that you've had a great time. And you probably remember that we make a craft or do some sort of little object lesson in the beginning. Today, we're going to actually make a toy that you can play with later. Our story is about Jonah and the big fish, and it's an incredible story, but I thought you guys might want to make your own big fish and Jonah to play with while you hear the story. So moms and dads at home, you will need a cup similar to this one, two googly eyes, or you could draw some eyes on, a balloon, a marker, and I happen to have, I don't even know what this is, but I think it's a basting tool that you squirt juices on your turkey with, and I had to use this, some tape, a piece of string or yarn, and a whale's tail. I also have a paintbrush here because we're going to use this to poke a hole, and a thumbtack. Obviously, we know the kids shouldn't be handling that on their own. All right, so let's begin. We're going to start with a cup. And I used the thumbtack to make a little hole inside the bottom of the cup, and then took the paintbrush just to widen it. We're gonna take the yarn and slide it through the hole, like so. Actually, you probably can use the paintbrush or a tool to push that yarn through, because it's a little difficult to get. And then you're gonna pull it through and tie a knot so it's gonna look like this. Just like that. And we're gonna set that aside for now. So what I did with the balloon is I took a balloon like this. I happened to use sand, which I put inside of the baster. And then I just squirted it inside of the balloon. But you can use rice or flour or anything like that. And then you tie a knot in it and you have like a little ball, which you're going to tie to the end of the string. All right, so that's done. Now we're gonna put on the whale's tail. I just drew that on my own. No template needed. And just tape that on the bottom, like so. And I happen to have some glue dots, but you can use regular glue. And we will put on eyes. Just like that, you see? All right, one last thing. We are going to draw Jonah right onto our balloon. And if you don't know the story, I'm gonna spill the beans and let you know that Jonah gets swallowed by a giant fish. And now you have a toy that you can play with. And Pastor Corey is gonna demonstrate for us later how to play this game. Before we get to our Bible story, we're going to get to listen to Ms. Jen sing a great song about our Bible story. Jen, thank you so much for that great song. I hope you guys had fun singing and dancing at home. And it's a great introduction to our story about Jonah, which can be found in the Bible. You may have a Bible like this one at home or a little bit different. The words are the same inside all the Bibles, even though the covers are different. So today, we're going to learn a story or hear a story about Jonah. And Jonah was a rather interesting guy in the Bible. He was faithful and a strong believer in God, and God asked him to do him a favor. He wanted him to go to this town called Nineveh. Can you guys say Nineveh? It's kind of a hard word to say. And he wanted him to go to Nineveh and warn the people of Nineveh that he didn't like their behavior, and that if they did not change their behavior, that God was going to punish them. But Jonah did not want to go there because he didn't like the people of Nineveh. They were bad. They did bad things and they were mean. Do you have any people like that in your life? I hope not. But Jonah didn't like them. So instead of going to Nineveh, he wanted to go someplace else really, really far away. And he wanted to run away to a place where God could not find him. And as he was trying to do that, he saw a ship, and he went on the ship where God could not find him. So he got on board of the ship. And when he got on the ship, he went down to the bottom and went to sleep. He thought, let me just stay down here and I'll hide. And then all of a sudden, it got very stormy out. And it was rocking back and forth on this ship, just like this. And it was crazy, the storm and the waves were just getting rockier and rockier and rockier. And the sailors on the ship started to get really worried and they didn't know what to do. So they started taking all these boxes and the loads of stuff they had and they were throwing it overboard. But it didn't matter, they thought that the ship was gonna totally capsize because it was just going back and forth and so bad. And Jonah woke up when they came down and they said, "We don't know what to do." And Jonah said, "You're gonna have to throw me overboard. It's because God has found me and he is so angry. And the only way to make the ship stop rocking is to throw me overboard." They didn't want to do it, but it was so scary. And they thought for sure that they weren't gonna make it through that storm. So they took Jonah and they threw him overboard. And all of a sudden, the waves stopped rolling and the ship stopped rocking. But as soon as Jonah got out into the ocean, a big giant fish came up. And do you know what that big giant fish did? It swallowed him whole. And now Jonah was inside of the big giant fish. And he was there for 3 whole days. He didn't know what was going to happen. It was dark and damp and smelly from all the fish that were inside that big whale. And he prayed and he prayed and he prayed. And I'm sure he was very worried and lonely and scared. But you know what? God heard his prayers, even at the bottom of the ocean, inside of this big giant fish. And since God is a great, merciful God, he decided that he was going to forgive Jonah. And he did forgive Jonah. But he asked Jonah to do what he had told him to do before. And then, after all of that Jonah had done, God decided that he was going to let Jonah go. And out of the blue, that whale spit out Jonah and swam away. And Jonah landed on the shore. And sure enough, he went to Nineveh and he warned all of those people and said what God told him to say, that if they did not change their ways, that they were going to be in big trouble. And do you know what they did? They believed Jonah and they repented and they said they were sorry. And God, being a merciful God, forgave all of them and they were saved. And Jonah did that. that's the end of that story, but it certainly wasn't the end of Jonah. Jonah still didn't understand why God had told him to go and help those people who were so bad. And he was out in this place and he had fallen asleep on the ground and you know what God did? He grew a tree over him to protect him from the shade. And Jonah was so thankful and grateful, and he fell asleep. And when he woke up, the tree had died. And he didn't understand that either. And he asked God, why did you do that? And why didn't you save my tree? And God said to Jonah, you cared more about this tree than you did about my people. And Jonah started to understand that the people were more important, and that he had to let go of his hate and to have forgiveness in his heart too, just like God did for those people. What a great story from the Bible. You should go check it out and read it again so that you can really understand what happened to Jonah and how his heart was changed by God and how he obeyed God and did what he was supposed to do. I want to thank you guys so much for coming today, and we have a closing song that's going to be just as much fun as the first two songs we heard. See you next time.
You You broke it.
Just kidding. Don't lose your patience.
Alice, I could do this all day. That's why you don't throw your toys. Forgot about that.